This is part two of using the Pythagorean theorem to find the length of a missing side of a right triangle. And in this video, we'll find the lengths of the missing sides in these three right triangles. This is part two of using the Pythagorean theorem to find the length of a missing side of a right triangle. So here's a picture of a right triangle where the lengths of the sides are A, B, and C. C is the longest side, the hypotenuse. And the formula is that A squared plus B squared equals C squared. Here's the first example. First problem, find the length of the unknown side in the right triangle. Give both the exact answer and the length rounded to the nearest tenth of a centimeter. So we're trying to find the length of this unknown side, which is a leg, because the hypotenuse is the longest side, which is opposite the right angle. So let's just call this x. All right, so see if you could write the equation and solve for x and figure out the exact length. Put it on pause and try that on your own. All right, so here we go. We know that we square each side and add it together, square each leg, so we have x squared plus 8 squared equals 12 squared. Remember, that's not the same as x plus 8 equals 12. That would be convenient, but it just wouldn't make any sense because, well, 12 has to be shorter than this side plus the 8. Okay, also I have not drawn this to scale, by the way, so you can't really tell from the picture which is longer. It looks like x is longer, but that's not necessarily true. All right, so we've got x squared plus 64 equals 144, and then we could subtract 64 from both sides. And that will give us x squared equals 80. So then x will be the square root of 80 because x stands for the length of that side. If x was not a length, it could also be negative the square root of 80, right? Because it could be a negative number as well. When you square it, you'll get 80. But in this case, it's a length, so it's the square root of 80. Now that is the exact length, square root of 80, but we can simplify that. So remember, one way of simplifying is, think of that as 16 times 5. You think of the perfect square in 80 as 16. And the square root of 16 is 4. So 4 gets to pop out, and you'll have 4 times the square root of 5. Now, you may know another way to simplify that, but that's one way. Now, remember, we're talking about how long that is in terms of centimeters. So my picture isn't very good at saying the 4 times the square root of 5. It's hard to tell how long that is really. So here's where we want to use the calculator to get the approximation. Say, how would you figure out what the square root of 80 was? You get out a calculator, do 80, and then punch the square root key. So here's a calculator here I have. I'm going to put in 80. And here's my square root, and I get 8.9442719. It goes on and on. You probably can't see it. But if I'm going to round it, it will be 8.9. So it's approximately 8.9. Now, notice I just did the square root of 80. I could have done the square root of 5 and then multiplied by 4, but it was easier just to put in the 80 in the square root. So now the question is, what's the exact answer? And we want to know the estimated answer. So we would say 4 square roots of 5 centimeters. That's the exact answer. And the other answer is approximately 8.9 centimeters. So now we look back at my picture, and this length, if it's 8.9, should be longer than 8. All right, so actually I didn't draw it too far off. All right, here's one for you to try. Find the length of the missing side, and this is a right triangle. So put the video on pause and see if you could find the length of the missing side. for this triangle. All right, this time the hypotenuse is not known. I'm going to call that C, just if you want to think of it as A squared plus B squared equals C squared. So we'll take one of the lengths of the leg squared, so that's 24 squared, that's one of the legs. And the other one is 7, so that's 7 squared. By the way, these are given in meters. M is not a variable, but I'm just going to use the numbers to figure out the answer, equals C squared. So we need to do 24 squared, and that would be 576, plus 7 squared is 49. And then we've got to add 576 and 49, that's 625, equals C squared. So if C squared equals 625, then C is the square root of 625. And 625 is a perfect square. You could try to put it in your calculator and you'll see it's 25. The square root of 25. I'm sorry, the square root of 625 is 25. So in this case, C is 25 and we don't need to estimate it. So we know the length of this missing side is 25 meters, and that's our answer. No need to estimate it because it's exact. There's not many triangles that are easy to find that have all integer sides. So in other words, no approximations need to be used. Usually there's a square root or two in there. All right, here's one more. And in fact, one of the sides we have already has a square root. And notice in this one, I don't have any dimensions as far as, I'm sorry, the units, whether it's centimeters, etc. So we're just working with the number parts. So what we don't know is this side over here, and I'll just call this x. You can call it a, b, x, whatever you like. And the hypotenuse is 8. So we're going to take and square each side. So we have x squared, that's the missing side, plus the 2 squared, it's a 2 squared. It's got to be the same as the 8 squared. So there's our equation. See if you can figure it out from here by putting the video on pause and trying it. All right, I'll go through it now. So we have x squared plus. Now I've got to square this 2 squared, it's a 2. So I need to square the 2 on the outside of the square root, which is 2 times 2, or 4. And then I have to do the square root of 2 times square root of 2, which is just 2. So 2 squared, it's a 2 squared, actually ends up being 8. And we have equals 8 squared, which is 64. So we have x squared plus 8 equals 64. And now we can subtract 8 from both sides. And that gives us x squared equals 56. Now I need to take the square root of 56. So we have x then would be the square root of 56, and we're going to look for the perfect square in 56 or any other method you know for simplifying the square root of 56. Just keep in mind that 56 is the same thing as the square root of 14 times 4. You could completely factor this to figure that out, but 4 is the perfect square and that comes out as a 2. So that means x in this case will be 2 square roots of 14. Now that's the exact answer. So the exact answer is 2 square roots of 14. And now we're going to approximate it. Okay. All right. Well, we could use our calculator to do the square root of 14 and then multiply by 2, but it's easier actually to just put in 56 and then do the square root. So get out your calculator. And you're just going to put in 56 and square root. And here's my calculator if you want to see it. I put in 56 square root. I have 7.4833 on and on. There's another 20 digits or so. So to the nearest tenth, that'll be 7.5. Now we look at our picture and see if that seems reasonable. If this is about 7.5, well, it's less than 8, so that part looks good. And by the way, 2 squareds of 2 is the same thing as the square root of 8. And or you could actually also simplify the square 2 times the square root of 2 with your calculator to find out, you know, how long that is approximately. And when you do 8 with a square root, you get about 2.8. So basically, this is approximately, I'm going to put approximately, that's about 2.8, and this is approximately 7.5, and that seems like it's reasonable, because when you add them up, it's bigger than 8. So we've got these two answers.